Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitananda Sauditam Sri Nanda 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 Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopijano Samayuktam Bindavanam Manu Vāñcha kalpataru vascha ki pāsindh bevacha Patitānang pāvune bhavishnabhibhyo namo namaha Mūkaṁ karoti vācālaṁ pangung laṁ haiti girim Yat ki pātam haṁ bandhi paramānanda madhavam Vṛndāvai tulsidebvai piyāvai keshvasacha Shna bhakti pade devi satta vattvai namo namaha Narayana namaskritta narancaiva narottamam Devim saraswatim vyasam tato jayo mudire Sankirtane krishna katho upadeshe Gauriya patrasya prakasanecha Sadanurakta guru bhakti yukto Bhakti Pramodakya Jagodvaruna Dhayam Sada Paribhavagnam Abhishchaduham Tithas Padam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam Bhittatiham Panatopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charana Ravindam Yat-pāda-pallavanaka-chandamani-chhataya Vispurujita-kimapikapavadu-svadarshi Purnanuragara-sasagara-sāra-murthi Sāradhikāmai-kadākipāma-kiroshi Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu-nittānanda Siyad-daita-gadādhara-sivasadi-gaura-bhakta-bindu Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajanulambita Bhujau Kanuka Badato Sanketanai Kapitaro Kamala Yatakshu Vishambaru Dijabaru Jugadharma Palo Bande Yagat Priyakaru Karuna Bhataru Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Namami Gange Tava Pada Pankajam Sura surair bandito dibharupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dadasinitam Bhavan rupen sada naranam Ganga tarang ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano Priyamananga Madapuharam Varana Sipurapati Bhajavishanatham Vagi Sajusha Badani Lakshmi Rajasya Chavakshashi Yasyasthi Hide Sambhid Vam Nishinga Mahambhaji Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, राम राम हरे राधा कृष्ण प्रणय विकृतिर्लादिनी शक्तिरस्माद् एकात्मनो अपि भुवि पुरा देहो भेदं गतौतो चैतन्य आख्यं प्रकटमधुना तद्वयं चैकमाप्तं राधावावदूति सुवलितं नौमि कृष्ण स्वरूपं राधा कृष्ण प्रणय विकृतिर् लादिनी शक्रियस्माद् एकात्मनो अपि भुवा भुवि पुरा देहोवेतं गतौतो चैतन्याख्यं प्रकटमधुना तद्वयं चैकमाप्तं राधाभावदूति सुवलितं नौमि कृष्ण स्वरूपं गौरी गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड दैट कृष्ण इज ऑल प्रीडोमिनेटिंग एब्सोल्यूट एंड श्रीमती राधारानी इज प्रीडोमिनेटेड एब्सोल्यूट एक्चुअली एज पर शास्त्र सिद्धांत राधा एंड कृष्ण नॉट सेम ऑल्सो एज पर भागवत glorification mahima skanda puran we can find documents sa eva sa actually radha and krishna together in combined form we can see chaitanya mahaprabhu coming in this material world so to Radha and Krishna combined and we get Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and actually point is that somebody can put question if Radha and Krishna combined because also Vaishnavanam Yatha Sambhu Shankar Bhagavan speaking to Parvati Devi Jang Evo Radhika Krishna Sa Evo Gaura Vigraha जच्च वृंदावनम देवी नवद्वीपंच तत्शुभम शंकर भगवान स्पीकिंग जंग एव राधिका कृष्ण स एव जंग एव राधिका कृष्ण स एव गौरव विग्रह जच्च वृंदावनम देवी नवद्वीपंच तत्शुभम नाउ इफ राधा एंड गोविंद कंबाइन एंड कमिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु देन इनसाइड चैतन्य महाप्रभु वी कैन गेट राधा एवं गोविंद बोथ Then where from this Gadadhar Pandit coming, this question coming? Actually it is written that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am not going in details, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to get the taste of, you know, Radha, Prema, Bika, what kind of excellence there, two or three reasons for why. So actually, if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming in the form of devotee but still Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to express this leela that how to get the taste of raga manjari bhav raganuga bhajan radha bhav so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually taking stealing radha bhav and body complexion molten gold and if radha bhav gone and golden complexion gone. Then the residue mean, what do you mean? Somebody can say, if Radharani coming inside Gauranga Mahaprabhu, if he can wed Radha, Govinda, both, then where from Gadadhar Pandit coming? Point is that, if the bhava of Radharani taken away, by Krishna, and the body complexion, then the rest actually there. Actually in this transcendental world, we cannot say this way. Because if Purnasya Purna Madayo Purna Meva Avasishvate, from Purna Vastu, if we can take out Purna, then Purna can, we can get Purna left. So Baba gone and actually body complexion, still Radharani is there. So Godadhar Pandit is Radharani. So to help Gaura Leela, she is coming in the form of Godadhar Pandit. About Godadhar Pandit, Gaura Ganadesh Deepika, there actually it is written, Sri Radha Prema Rupa Japura Brinda Vaneshwari Sa Sri Godadharo Gaura Vallabha Panditaksho. It is written, Sri Radha Prema Rupa Japura Brinda Vaneshwari Sri Radha Prema Rupa, total form of Prema, full Prema. Sri Radha Prema Rupa Japura Vrindavaneshwari Vari Radhani Sasi Sa Sri Godadharo Gauravallabha Panditakshaha, who is now we know in the form of Godadhar Pandit. He is himself actually Radharani coming in this form. Now I already discuss how it is possible. Also in Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, Godadhara Pandit Prabhur Shakti Avatar. Godadhara Pandit Prabhu Shakti Avatar Antaranga Bhakta Kori Ganon Jahar. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Godadhara Pandit is a Shakti Avatar of Prabhu. You can remember some days before when I was speaking Harikatha before going to Vrindavan, I was discussing one sloka, Bande Guru No Bande Gurun Isho Vaktan Isho Mishavatar Kan Tat Prakasanscha Tat Saktihi Krishna Chaitanya Sangakam. So Isho Bhakto Isho Bhakto Isho Avatar Ishwar Swayam Bhagavan Isha Shakti, so in different form. So in the form of Shakti, Isha Avatar, Isha Prakash, and Isha Swayam, and in the form of Shakti, and Isha. So, Bande Guru Na Isha Bhaktan, Isha Bhaktan, Bande Guru Na Isha Bhaktan, Isha Misha Avatar Kaana, Tat Prakashansa Tat Shakti Hi Krishna Chaitanya Sangakam. Panchatatmatakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Sarupakam, we sing this sloka. Actually in five from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one Adyagyan Tattva, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is one and single Adyagyan Tattva, but coming in five different from. One is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, then Isha Prakash, actually Advaita, actually Nityananda Prabhu, Isha Avatar, actually Advaita Gosai, Isha Shakti, Isha Bhakta mean Sivasadi there, and Isha Shakti mean actually Godadhar Pandit. So right from the beginning we can find in Gaur Lila, there in Navadip Dham we can find Godadhar Pandit, you know, manifesting Lila with Gauranga Mahaprabhu all the time. So when actually all the time, actually Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad compiling, giving this our Nitya Navadvip Leela, I mean Gaur Leela, Ashtakalin Gaur Leela, there you can find that all the time Godadhar Pandit is there. Godadhar Pandit is always there with Nimai, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, all the time Godadhar Pandit is there. So sometime actually Jogopit we can find in Vrindavan. Also we can find Jogopit here in Navadip Dham sometime. We can think this way, different kind of Leela going on. But actually Panchatatmatakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Sarupam, with this sloka we know, same Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, same Advaigyan Tattva in five different forms. So actually when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was manifesting this Leela, what kind of Leela? Actually after coming back from Gaya, after offering funeral cake to onto the lotus feet of Vishnu Pad Padma in the name of Father Jagannath Mishra, then after coming back, expressing different kind of leela, is exclusive leela, which was not possible before. So in this way, Mahaprabhu day by day showing this Vipralamba Bhava, somebody could realize, somebody couldn't realize fully. So Gadadhar Pandit, Sivas Pandit, they could realize very, very good that Mahaprabhu now going to express this kind, the reason for why Mahaprabhu coming, going to express this leela now. Now anyway, after taking sannyas in Katwa, Mahaprabhu gone from home and without speaking to other devotees, and some devotees knowing actually Sivas, actually or other devotees, they are knowing Nityananda, they are knowing it. So except that Mahaprabhu not going to speak anything about this leela, after going to there in Katwa, after taking sannyas, Mahaprabhu started going to Vrindavan Dham. Anyway, I am not going into details. So after that, we can find ultimately Mahaprabhu was bound to go to Advaita Bhavan. From there, ultimately Mahaprabhu going to Nilachal Dham. This way Mahaprabhu gone. After that, their Nilachal Leela, actually when Mahaprabhu took sannyas, then Gadadhar Pandit also took decision to go away from home. And he was bound to take Khetra Sannyas, because Khetra Sannyas means in Nilachal Dham, Mahaprabhu doing Leela. There actually Gadadhar Pandit was bound to take Khetra Sannyas to stay with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu all the time. Khetra Sannyas means you will have to take vow so that you cannot go out of this Khetra, is Dham. Within this Dham, you will have to stay whole life, you cannot go outside. This way, actually, Gadadhar Pandit took Khetra Sannyas and started staying with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there. And see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving exclusive seva to Advaita, to Gadadhar Pandit is Shakti, that is Tota Gopinath. Tota Gopinath was discovered from the sand inside. So after installing this seva, so Gadadhar Pandit was giving this seva to him. So now I can go back to the previous leela, I mean Navadvip leela, to point out one thing. What is there actually, when Gadadhar Pandit is doing leela all the time with Gauranga Mahaprabhu, in Sananda Sukhada Kunj, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also writing Kirtan, Sananda Sukhada Kunje Gadadhare Kori Bame. Bame means left hand side keeping Gadadhar, Gauranga Mahaprabhu manifesting different kind of. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, installing this seva there, Gaur Gadadhar, Guru Maharaj also. According to the installment of deities, you can understand the rasa bodha of any Mahajan. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, in this is Sananda Sukhada Kunja there, Gauranga Mahaprabhu used to come with Gadadhar playing here and there all the time, taking curds and milk, cheese in the house of all Ghosh. This way playing all the time. So this first time of Gauranga Mahaprabhu is always with Gadadhar Pandit right from the beginning. So one day actually Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu crying with the name of Pundarik Vidyanidhi. Nobody knows why Mahaprabhu shouting Pundarik Bapre, he is shouting. And shortly devotees could realize that for whom Mahaprabhu shouting. Within a short period of time, actually this Pundarik Vidyanidhi, who is actually Vishwanu Maharaj in his Krishna Leela, and in Gaur Leela is Pundarik Vidyanidhi is coming and joining Gaur Leela. So nobody knows his glories. So one day actually Mukundo always singing the glories of Pundarik Vidyanidhi, because no Mukundo and Pundarik Vidyanidhi from same place, they know actually well known to him. But Gadadhar Pandit manifesting Leela, that he like to take darshan of the lotus feet of Pundarik Vidyanidhi. So Mukundo saying, okay, let us go. So with Mukundo, Gadadhar Pandit going to take darshan of Pundarik Vidyanidhi. But while entering room, Gadadhar Pandit gone mad. How is that possible? We heard Krishna Bhakti is usually Niskinchan, but here you find is a like king, or like, you know, son-in-law, all his, you know, clothes and everything, and so nice, all back brass hair with nice scent coming, nice oil, and in body also there is costly, you know, scent there. So everything there, and he is chewing betel leaf, very nice, like king, those king, they used to chew this way. He is chewing. Then Gadadhar Pandit, when could see this mood, Gadadhar Pandit started thinking, it was good when I was not coming. Now I come, I find this is what kind of devotion it is. Then actually Mukundu could realize the mind of Gadadhar Pandit. It is one kind of Leela. Gadadhar Pandit not knowing is not possible, but Leela. Then Mukundo started singing one sloka from 10th canto in Bhagavatam. Baraha pira natabarabapu karnayo karnikaram vibhadavasa kanaka kopi sambhayayantin jamalam randhana vena radara sudaya purayana gopa pindai Brindaranam Sapajaramanam Pravishad Gita Kirti. As soon as Mukundo singing this sloka from Srimad Bhagavatam, then Pundarik Vidyanidhi started shouting. And all, you know, all started shouting and tearing his own chest, and all clothes become dirty. All everything, all here, back brass here become very dirty, all, you know. Then Gadadhar Pandit could realize, oh, a pure devotee can never be, you know, understood. It's not possible to understand a pure devotees. That day he was speaking, no? Prabhupada speaking, Guru Vaishnava, Supreme Lord and Guru Vaishnava can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. Though Gadadhar Pandit is Radharani, and actually Pundarik Vidyanidhi is the father of Radharani, so was still this kind of Leela manifesting. So this way, Gadadhar Pandit started thinking that I have done great aparadha. Okay, I shouldn't have think that way. I should not think that way. So this way, actually, then what to do? Aparadha is there. Then actually he took decision to take Diksha from Pundarik Vidyanidhi. So Pundarik Vidyanidhi giving Diksha to Gadadhar Pandit. This way this Pundarik Vidyanidhi become guru of Gadadhar Pandit. Remember Gadadhar Das, Gadadhar Pandit, there are so many actually. Actually, Gadadhar Das also there. So, Gadadhar Das also Shakti, but Gadadhar Das actually is staying there in Aryadaha, Calcutta, one place actually. And it was also very nice. Actually, I can discuss all. Now, actually, Prabhupada wants to say, Deeparchireva, this sloka actually, you should remember. Dasantaram abhupetva dipayati vibhritu hetu samana dharma jastadrik eva vishnutaya vibhati. This sloka Govindam adipurusham tamam bhajami. Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking. Actually, when Krishna is the all-providing Lord, everybody knowing is the original cause. Govindam adipurusham tamaham bhajami, Ishvaraha Paramakrishna Sachidananda Vigraha anadi radi govinda sarva karana karan, everybody knowing. But actual point is that Prabhupada speaking in his letter to some devotee who is asking some question, Prabhupada speaking actually originally Krishna is there, from there all Vishnu Tattva is like one lamp is glowing from originally, from that lamp, same type of lamp, if we take fire and start, you know, and then the lamp, all lamps, then we can say same power, same everything there. So there is no difference. This way, Prabhupada speaking, all, you know, Supreme Lord, when coming in the form of, you know, Balaji Maharaj, after that, actually in the form of, you know, Sishti Tattva, in Sishti Tattva you can find Karana Navasai and Garbhada Gosai, Kherada Gosai, all Vishnu Tattva. So all Vishnu Tattva is similar. From one lamp, if I lighten or other lamp or of same quality, then I cannot understand which one is the original. If we know this lamp is original, then it's okay, it is marked. Otherwise, it is not possible to understand. Only, actually, the difference is that only regarding Leela. Regarding Leela, Krishna is doing Leela all the time. So regarding Leela, we can find some. Otherwise, originally Vishnu Tattva was the same. Similarly, from Radha Kataksha Stotram, you must know, I think you know. Anantakoti Vishnu Loko Namra Padmajarchite Himadriya Pulomuja Biranchija Baro Prade. I mean, what do you mean? Actually, in this sloka is there that Vishnu Tattva, Bhagavan Sri Krishna is there, but I already told when I was speaking about what Prabhupada told, that Vishnu Tattva, Krishna is all, you know, predominating absolute, and Radharani is predominated absolute. This is the difference. So when from Krishna different kind of avatar can come, similarly from Radharani's lotus feet, all in infinity, Brahmando, wherever, you know, different kind of Leela going on of Vishnu Tattva, they are like Bamandev. So in that case, Radharani can come in the form of, you know, Lakshmi in different, and Nishingadev, that time also, Lakshmi Nishingo, and, you know, Baraha Lakshmi, Kurmon Lakshmi, different form. So according to Leela, so Radharani, from Radharani's lotus feet, all Sakhi Tattva, all coming. So like from Krishna, all, you know, Vishnu Tattva, everything coming. From Radharani, all different Sakhi Tattva, infinity Sakhi Tattva coming from Radharani's lotus feet. And that Radharani now coming to help Gaur Leela, to assist Gaur Leela. So, Radharani coming in the form of Gadadhar Pandit right now. So, somebody putting question to Prabhupada, actually Vishnubhya Tattva is Radharani. Actually, Vishnubhya Tattva, I already told, that Vishnubhya Tattva is actually in Gaur Leela. In Gaur Leela, you can find that three different kind of Shakti coming. Leela, Balina, Nila Shakti, Bhu Shakti, you know, Sri Shakti coming. So Sri Shakti is that actually Lakhi Priyadevi. And Bhu Shakti is actually, Vishnu Priyadevi coming. So ultimately all coming from Radharani, no doubt actually. Now Prabhupada speaking, that actually Bhakshesar Pandit, Narahari Sarkar Thakur, Madhumati Babu, and actually Sivananda Sen, Champaglata, all different kind of, you know, Leelas are there. all coming from originally from Radharani's Tattva. So Gadadhar Pandi is non-different from Radharani, still has some speciality in this Gaur Lila. Because in Radharani Lila, you can find Radharani sometimes expressing a different kind of, you know, man Lila, different kind of man. But in Gadadhar Lila, you cannot find that kind of complicated man. Ahe riva premna gatihi sabhava kutilo bhavet. The way of prema, the way of prema is zigzag, like snake, a snake move. When snake traveling, zigzag move. So it is written, Ahe Urva Goswami was writing, Ahe riva gatihi premna sabhava kutilo bhavet. The love of prema is kutil, very complicated. Those who are not, those who have not any practical experience, they cannot understand the mood of love. Anyway, I am not going to mean material love, but in aprakita jagat, Radharani's love, and in a mood, different kind of man expressed is topmost actually, and also this kind of man also available in Chaitanya Chanda Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu sometime expressing this kind of lila, but since the bhava of Radhani already taken away, stolen by Krishna and keeping in him actually in the form of Gauranga, so we cannot find any complicated bhava with Gadadhar Pandit. It's very, very simple, like, you know, Rukini, you see. So the bhava of Rukini is very simple. If Krishna Bhagavan going to play some trick with her, then she can start crying. She is going to think that Krishna going to leave me. Maybe he is joking. Someday Krishna joking with, in Dwaraka, joking with Rukini. Rukini, you are actually a daughter of king, big king actually. So actually, why you are going to marry me? I am penniless. You should not. You have done mistake actually. So you can go and again choose, use your, you know, partner according to your use. Then Krishna making this kind of joking, when Rukmini Devi thought that Krishna going to leave me, then Rukmini Devi went faint. Then Krishna again catching her and giving water and a hand fan, playing hand fan. And suddenly, she came back to his consciousness. This way, Radharani's mood is very complicated, but Rukini's mood is not so complicated. But we, actually, Rukini, Shatabhama, Jambavati, who not? Everything coming from the lotus feet of Radharani, no doubt. But here, actually, we cannot find any complicacy with Gadadhar Pandit. All the way is very simple, very simple. So Gadadhar Pandit doing this kind of lila, so Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving this kind of special seva to him. Actually, the seva of this Tota, one place there, Tota Gopinath, giving seva there. So Gadadhar Pandit is very satisfied with his seva because he is going to serve Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And also Tota Gopinath, both all the time doing seva of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, all the time doing seva of, you know, Tota Gopinath. And it was the main seva of Gadadhar Pandit to do seva, Raganuga seva from heart of, you know, this Tota Gopinath. At the same time, he used to read Bhagavatam in the afternoon time, all the time. So it was his usual seva. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I mean Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, used to come, usually used to go there in Aitota to hear Harikatha, Bhagavatkatha from Gadadhar Pandit all the time, almost every day. So every day hearing Harikatha and requesting him that I like to hear Prahlad Charitra, I like to hear, you know, Dhruva Charitra. Mahaprabhu repeatedly speaking. This way, Mahaprabhu wanted to give us indication that don't try to jump into Raganuga Bhajan directly right now. First of all, if you can get stability in your bhajan, first you try to understand Prahlad Maharaj, first you try to understand the mood of Dhruva Maharaj. And so all the time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to speak this way. And sometime going to take prasadam, used to go there to take prasadam in Aitota there. One day actually, Gadadhar Pandit cooking, and actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going there. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, and in this prasad, I have also my right. Okay, then they make division on this prasadam. Probably Nityananda Babu was also there that time. So they make three shares, three parts, this prasadam, and they are very happy to take prasadam this way. So now point is that whenever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to Jagannath Mandir or Gundicha, dancing in front of chariot, all the time going to see, all the time Gadadhar Pandit is staying with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, sometime coming to Gambhira Mandir, from Gambhira Mandir, this Tota Gopina, I Tota is not so far, very near. It's a half a kilometer, not even half a kilometer, if you know the exact route. So actually, I like to speak some special lila. Actually, one day, Ballabhacharya actually coming to Purushottam Dham, because previously Mahaprabhu went to their house in Allahabad. From then, is growing some attraction from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But he wanted to recite Srimad Bhagavatam commentary in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Okay, but the mood was very negative mood. What kind of mood? In front of Mahaprabhu is speaking that I cannot accept the commentary of Siddha Samipad. So I have written a new commentary. I cannot accept Siddha Samipad. Then Mahaprabhu become very angry. Because Mahaprabhu, actually by the grace of Nishingadev, it is written about Siddha Samipad, je Siddharam Bhetti Nishinga Prasadat. If at all somebody going to know in details the meaning of Bhagavatam, Siddha Samipad is a must, he is knowing. By the mercy of Nishingadev, he is going to know. So, Siddharam Bhetti Nishinga Prasadat, by the mercy of Nishingadev, he is knowing everything, all in details. Of Krishna, but actually Srimad Bhagavatam is equal to Krishna. From different angle, different commentator, actually Vishwanath Chakravartipad, Vijay Raghav, or other actually, they can write in different way. That's not a bad. But point is that when speaking this way, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very angry. Mahaprabhu speaking actually, you are not going to accept Samipad, who is the original commentator of Srimad Bhagavatam. So Mahaprabhu was very angry and started speaking, Shami nahi mane tare beshamadriguni. Who is not going to obey husband, he is actually pros. This way. Then Ballabhacharya became very silent. He started thinking, why he became so angry? So then after that, onward, one by one, he started satisfying Mahaprabhu, but Mahaprabhu is never satisfied with him because he is so much puffed up. He thinks himself, I am erudite scholar, is thinking so much, false ego. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Sri Radha Premurupa, Japura Vrindavaneswari, Shasi Gadadharo, Gauro Vallava Panditakshakaha. I was speaking about how Vallabhacharya going to insult, you know, ignore the main commentator of Srimad Bhagavatam, Siddha Saipad, and Mahaprabhu was very angry. She wanted to, you know, ignore him. This way, day by day, he is not going to establish his own Siddhanta in front of all Gaur Parshads. In front of Gaur Parshads, in front of sometime in front of Advaita Gosai, sometime in front of, you know, Sarvam Vartaja Jodet, always and every time he like to put one issue on which he can start debating. But they always like to avoid him. One day, for he writing the glories of Krishna Nam and again coming with a request in front of Sri Mahaprabhu, if you at all hear this my writing, I have written the glories of Krishna, glorification. Mahaprabhu speaking, actually I am murkha, I am illiterate. I don't understand the meaning of Krishna, only I know Nandanandan, Yashodanandan, Krishna, this much I know. I am less interested to know anything about Krishna and other glories because I cannot understand. So you can go to anywhere else. Then in that case you are also feeling insulted. This way day by day he is feeling insulted any time. Someday speaking in front of all Gaur Parsad, that why you are speaking the name of, you know, Krishna. Actually, usually it is the rule in, you know, Vedic culture that in our, you know, Hindu Shastra, that one wife should not speak out the name of husband. There is the rules. Then Advaita Gosa, all, you know, devote, all there present, they say in front of you Jagannath Dharma is that the judge is sitting. You can ask him. Then they are speaking this way. Then actually Mahaprabhu started giving answer. Mahaprabhu started giving answer. Actually, those who are chastity lady always going to follow the instruction of husband. Chastity lady, it is the duty of chastity lady to carry out the order of husband, nothing else. So chastity lady can speak. It is the Krishna giving direct order. Mahaprabhu also, you know, Pithivite achi yato nagaradigam sarvatta pacharayvenam mor nam, or in nam mahatta, everywhere it is written. So Krishna giving, you know, instruction to speak his name, to actually chant his name and shout. And this way he was bound to set up. This way actually one by one he cannot establish any Siddhanta in front of Gaur Parsad, everything. They are like, you know, sun, you know, thousands of sun god, one, Advaita Gosai, Nityananda, all powerful soul. So one day, he took decision to approach Gadadhar Pandit with his soft personality. So he went there in Aitota and paying Dandavat, and Gadadhar Pandit speaking, why, what reason you have come to, because Gadadhar Pandit knowing that Mahaprabhu, my Prabhu, always went to ignore him. What is the problem? He has come here. What I can speak? Because Prabhu Antarjami all the time can know and can chase me sometime. So actually, he started speaking, I have written the glories of Krishna Naam. So if you please hear, then I can feel very happy. Otherwise, I am feeling insulted everywhere. So Gadadhar Pandit is very soft personality. He cannot speak that when Prabhu ignored you, all Parshada Prabhu, I am not going to hear. This way Gadadhar Pandit cannot speak. He is very soft personality. And on the other hand, Vallabhacharya is from a high, you know, high status. So how he can insult? So when he started reading the glories of Krishna Naam, then Gadadhar Pandit was very fearful because he was thinking about Mahaprabhu. Je Mahaprabhu is Antarjami, he can understand in what situation. In what situation I was bound to hear. I have no intention to hear. In what situation I was bound to hear. So Mahaprabhu Antarjami, sitting inside, everybody's heard. he can really understand. So I am not going to fear about that. He can give punishment or can love me, whatever he likes. But I am thinking about all the parsadas of Mahaprabhu. So if they are going to criticize me that you are going to get the association of that Vallabhacharya, whereas Mahaprabhu wanted to ignore him, then there is a big problem. Then actually Gadadhar Pandit started praying unto the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu to get some solution. Then someday, actually, he was bound to hear what to do. Then after some day, and Gadadhar Pandit reaching Gambhira Mandir, and Mahaprabhu started speaking very heavy, because we are Antarjami, he is speaking, okay, you are going to take his association, this, that. Gadadhar Pandit started crying, because you know everything. I was not willing what to do. This way, actually, when Gadadhar cut crying heavily, then Mahaprabhu laughing. Mahaprabhu speaking, I know everything. I wanted to play with you, and you couldn't understand my mood. You already started crying. Anyway, this way, all the time, Gauranga Mahaprabhu want to play with Gadadhar Pandit all the time. One day, actually, Gadadhar Pandit speaking, I forget my mantra. Before that, I would say that Vallabhacharya, by the association of Gadadhar Pandit, someday he was interested. He was expressing his interest to do Kishore Krishna Bhajan, very Bal Krishna Bhajan. Their mood, actually. There is a Pushti Marg. They are now speaking, their Marg is Pushti Marg. Actually, to be frank, they are from Gaudiya society. But at present, out of their false ego, they are not going to obey. Vitthalnath, or the son of Vallabhacharya, he was also. So later on, they took decision to change this mood. So they identified themselves as Vallabh Sampradaya. They are going to identify the Pushti Marg, but actually they are from Gaudiya Sampradaya. Because why? When one day, actually, Vallabhacharya requesting Gadadhar Pandit to get Kishore Gopal Mantra, Kam Gayatri Adi, etc. Then Gadadhar Pandit speaking, I cannot give this mantra because my Prabhu is there. Gauchandra, my Prabhu is there. Without his permission, I can do nothing. So I cannot give mantra. Then actually, again, Vallabhacharya came in front of Gauranga Mahaprabhu to pay dandavat and requesting him, please excuse me if I have done any mistake. After that, Mahaprabhu giving some advice to him. Actually, you are going to express your false ego. This is not good. First point is that you are great Pandit. Second is you are from high heritage. So you should have a humble attitude. But you are speaking this way. You are going to ignore the commentary of Siddha Saipad, whereas whole world going to accept him. Because by the grace of Nishingadev, he wrote. So, is very great offense. So, you will have to beg for pardon unto his lotus feet and try to write all commentary under the guidance of Siddha Saipad. If you are going to write anything under the guidance of Siddha Saipad, then everybody can accept. If you are going to ignore Siddha Saipad, you are going to write commentary, nobody can accept your commentary. Or your energy can go in vain. Be careful. Then he was bound to accept the instruction and by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. By then he was growing some softness after looking his position. Because all Gaur Parsad, they are actually like stars and moons. In front of them, Sarvam, what he actually, Vallabhacharya find himself is very, very weak. So after that he is requesting in front of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I like to take mantra from Gadadhar Pandit. If you give order, then I can take. without your permission, he cannot give mantra to me. Then after that, by the order of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he was bound to give this mantra, Kishore Gopal mantra, Kishore Krishna mantra, he was bound to give. So after some days, actually, Gadadhara Pandit coming in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gauranga, and speaking, I don't know how I forget my mantra. You forget? Yes. I somehow forget my, it is one kind of lila. Somehow I forget my mantra, so I cannot remember my mantra. Could you please give this mantra to me? Mahaprabhu say, no. Actually, if we forget mantra, you will have to again take from your Gurudev, Pundarik Vidyanidhi. So Pundarik Vidyanidhi is shortly coming, you can take mantra from me. So Pundarik Vidyanidhi came and Gadadhara Pandit again took mantra. It is one kind of lila. Actually, there is so many lila with this Pundarik Vidyanidhi and Jagannath, everything I am not going to speak in details. Time is very limited. At the same time, there is an interruption in Harikatha. I never like this kind of Harikatha. So what to do? So one day actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took decision to go to Bangla, from there to Vrindavan Dham, then Gadadhara Pandit also took decision to go with him. Then Mahaprabhu speaking, no, you will have to stay here. You will have to stay here to do the seva. I give you this seva, so you will have to do this seva. You cannot go. But he said, no, without you I cannot live. Without you, I cannot live. So Gadadhara Pandit Rahila Prabhupase Jameswari Prabhujare Karaila Avase. Mahaprabhu already gave him this place in Aitota and the seva of Tota Gopina. But still he is not at all ready. He cannot bear the, you know, separation of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is saying, it is your duty to stay here. You will have to stay in Nilachal Dham because you have taken, you know, vow, Khetra Sanyas, anyway you have to stay. To me, then Gadadhara Pandit started speaking, I cannot leave your association. You can break your vow. You have taken Bhakatra Sandha. Speaking, wherever you are staying, home I go, wherever you are staying, that is Nilachal. So I don't care. So this way, if I am going to lose my seva, Tota Gopinath, if I am going to lose my sannyas brata, still I am not going to think anything. So only I need your association, tathapi, you know, so, Amar ei khetra sannyas nashto hiya jao, if my khetra sannyas is going to be, you know, finished, I am going to lose my khetra sannyas, still, I am not going to leave your association. Then Mahaprabhu speaking, it is my desire you stay and do seva here. Gadadhara Pandit, that what to speak about Tota Gopinath Seva, if I look at your lotus feet, that is my koti crores of seva result I can get. So I am not going to leave your association anyway. So Mahaprabhu giving argument one by one, requesting, but anyway, Pandit is not at all ready to leave his association. Then Mahaprabhu started for Gaur Dham. So Mahaprabhu going, Gadadhara also backside following him. After covering long distance, again Mahaprabhu speaking, now you come out of Khetra, you break your, you know, sannyas vrata, now you are satisfied, you are going to give me more punishment, You like to stay with me? We are going to seek your own, you know, desire? You are going to seek your own, you know, happiness? You would like to stay with me? You are going to seek your own happiness? You are going to break Khetra Sanyas, at the same time you are going to leave your seva of Tota Gopinath. Both way, I am going to get punishment, you know. So, when Gadadhar Pandit started following Mahaprabhu, then Mahaprabhu started walking and giving strict instruction not to go. Then Gadadhar Pandit fell down on ground, unconscious. Then when Mahaprabhu come back to Nilachal Khetra and speaking in front of devotees, that I was bound to leave Gadadhar. Gadadhar was very sorry. I couldn't, you know, bear. So I couldn't, this time I couldn't get to go to Vrindavan. Gadadhar, I leave Gadadhar Pandit halfway. Say, he was supposed to go with me. I was very strict with him. He was very sorry for that. So that's why, that is the reason for why I couldn't go to Vrindavan this time. Again, I can go someday by all your permission. So this way, actually, all the time, Gadadhar Pandit is staying with Mahaprabhu all the time and doing different kinds of lila. And Gadadhar Pandit, all the Shakti, I mean Sivananda Sen or, you know, the Bhakeshwar Pandit, or, you know, this Madhumati Prabhu Narahari Sarkar, all different Shaktis, manifestation of different Shaktis from the lotus feet of Radharani, I mean from the lotus feet of Gadadhar Pandit. This is the main Siddhanta. So this way, whole life Gadadhar Pandit started doing seva, and in the last age, when Mahaprabhu disappeared from this planet, Mahaprabhu disappeared. In that case, Mahaprabhu and disappeared, Gadadhar Pandit was, you know, almost like mad. So after that, by the instruction of Mahaprabhu, started doing seva. Vipralamba Bhava was very high, so it's impossible to bear, but still doing seva, Gadadhar. Gadadharir Prananath. This kind of word going on in Vaishnava society, Gaudiya Vaishnava society, Gadadharir Prananath. I was speaking, na? Gadadharir Prananath. I was speaking the mood of Chandravali. Chandravali speaking, Chandavali thinking that I am Krishna's. But Radharani is thinking that my Krishna. So this is the difference. So here also Gadadharir Prananath, this is the, you know, mood of Gadadhar Pandit. So last time when Mahaprabhu disappeared from this and his material planet is here, then Gadadhar Pandit also almost mad, gone mad, but still doing seva, Vipralamba Bhava, doing same seva. But when Gadadhar Pandit growing age, day by day Gadadhar Pandit cannot give mala, garland to Tota Gopinath, because Tota Gopinath is very long. But after that, Gadadhar Pandit, when grow old age, cannot offer mala to Gopinath. So one day actually, by the request of Gadadhar Pandit, he fold his leg and sit down. From then we can find Gadadhar Pandit, actually Gopinath, nowhere. You can find in the whole world, nowhere we can find that Gopinath is sitting. Only there, to help Gadadhar to do seva, Chota Gopinath was bound to sit, and from then we can find in sitting pose Gadadhar Pandit all the time in sitting pose there. So this way actually, doing this kind of lila, to take the darshan of Gadadhar Pandit, Narottama Thakur also wanted to take darshan after Gauranga Mahaprabhu gone actually. This way, Gadadhar Pandit up to the last moment doing lila there and live, and there actually up to the last moment of life doing this kind of lila. So you see, Gauru Shakti Gadadhar, this way we can understand that the mood of Gadadhar Pandit was just like Rukkini, because the bhava of Radharani taken away stolen away. That's why we can discover this kind of Leela with, actually is Radharani, no doubt actually. So, Gadadhar Pandit ki jai. So, Vancha Kalpataruvasya Kipasindhi Vyavacha Patitanang Pavane Bhyo Vaishnavi Bhyo Namo Namaha. Sri Radha Prema Rupa Japura Vrindavaneswari Sri Gadadharo Gauravallabha Pandita Akshakaha Vancha Kalpataruvasya Kipasindhi Vyavacha Patitanang Pavane Bhyo Namo Namaha.